If you're there, give me a wave. I can't see you. Where's that wave? Are you waving? Oh, there you are. I can see you. Welcome to our Roving Crib Nativity service. Are you ready to hear the story of Christmas?
Yeah!
Are you ready to see our crib being filled with all the Christmas characters?
Yeah!
Are you ready to see Nigel the donkey?
Yeah!
I know I am. Fantastic. But first, let's start with singing one of our Christmas carols, O Little Town of Bethlehem. Instead of telling the nativity story in church, we're bringing our roving nativity story right to you in your own homes. We've been out and about all over Pannal and Beckwithshaw recording our story in a new and fun way. You might recognise some of the places. Look out for places you know. So, narrator, take it away.
Welcome to our Christmas story. We retell it every year. How God came from heaven's glory, came to make his home right here. Jesus lying in a manger, born in all our mess and fuss, made us friends who once were strangers, Son of God who lives with us. Soon we'll meet the shepherds, wise men, all the usual Christmas crew, and perhaps another story, one that's now involving you. In our world of joy and darkness, in our laughter, pain and care, Jesus came so we could know that God is with us everywhere. So our story starts, as always, with an angel, Gabriel. visiting the home of Mary. Was she busy? Who can tell?
Oh, all day long I'm cooking, sweeping, feed the chickens, knead the dough. Honestly, it's never ending. Time to sit down for a mo.
But as soon as Mary rested, someone knocked upon her door. Grumpily, she went to answer, not expecting what she saw.
Greeting, Mary, highly favoured. I've come to you from God, with a message straight from heaven. Oh, you look a little odd. Yes, I realise you're frightened. Seems to happen quite a lot. People see the wings and halo, gives them a nasty shock. Would you like a glass of water? Do sit down, dear. There's a love. That's much better. Here's a message I bought from God above.
Gabriel explained to Mary God had chosen her to be mother of a special baby, God's gift for humanity.
Don't want to seem ungrateful, but there's just one tiny thing I should mention. Just in passing, see my hand? No wedding ring.
Oh, Mary, don't get all Beyoncé. It's okay, the child will be. Not the son of your fiancé, but of God, the one in three. Father God will send his spirit and become the Holy Son. The child you'll bear will be the Son of God, the three in one.
Wow, that's quite a thing you're asking. God himself will come to stay. But I am the Lord God's servant. Let it happen, as you say.
So the angel bowed and left her. Mary sat and drank some tea. Called up her fiancé, Joseph. What would his reaction be?
Thank you.
Right across the town from Mary, Joseph had a woodwork shop. He was busy making benches when a phone call made him stop.
Joseph here. Yep, all tables mended, doors, windows, fences too. Yep. Yep, carving the wall of Nazareth. Who's there? Mary. Oh, it's you.
Joseph dear, I have news to tell you. We're going to have a child. God's own son. An angel told me. Now, Joseph, please don't get riled.
Oh, this is disappointing. Not that I'm mad or cross, but I must do what's righteous. I'm sorry, but the wedding's off.
Joseph planned to do this quietly, caring still for Mary's plight. Gabriel had news for Joseph in a dream that very night.
Joseph, son of David, listen! You are frightened, and that's okay. It's all right to marry Mary. You'll still have your wedding day. Mary said the babe she's bearing is from God, and that is right. Call him Jesus, which means saviour. He will be this dark world's light.
Joseph made it up with Mary, and they set a wedding day. But before they picked the bridesmaids, something happened.
Mary, I've just got this letter. I'm afraid it's not good news, because it's from them, you know, the Romans. It's about our taxes. It's time to pay. In Bethlehem.
What? You mean we've got to travel while I'm pregnant? That's too hard. Can't we just pay by direct debit? Visa Pay or MasterCard?
Sorry, sweetie, not invented. It's Bethlehem or bust. Yeah, I'll start packing. Yeah, you put your feet up. Comfy footwear is a must.
To Bethlehem they travelled, 'cause of Joseph's family tree. Walked for days and days to get there. Were they tired? Guess we'll see.
Nearly there now, Mary darling. Won't be long now till supper time. We can stay with Bob, my uncle, in his guest room. You'll be fine.
Really hope so, Joseph dearest. Baby's nearly on his way. When we get there, call the midwife. Think you're going to be a dad today.
Uncle Bob had made it lovely, but the room was very small. Mary much preferred it downstairs, just beside the donkey's stall. So that night, as the stars were twinkling, Mary's tiny babe was born. Joseph filled the donkey's trough with hay and blankets, soft and warm.
Can I hold him? Will he like me? Do you you think he'll call me Dad? Ooh, God's own son just wet his nappy. Mary, dear, you're looking sad.
I was thinking, will he be a carpenter like you, you reckon? Making chairs and tables, or does something very different beckon? Will he grow to be like you, or will he take his father's job? Nestling in your arms, I see the face of human, soul of God.
As they gazed in awe and wonder at their baby sleeping sound, silently, beyond their vision, all of heaven gathered around. God no longer just in glory, but right here where humans dwell. God made flesh to be God with us, Jesus, our Emmanuel. Meanwhile, on a distant hillside, shepherds sat there, tending sheep. Amos, Seth, apprentice Colin, round the campfire, half asleep. All at once they heard some singing, saw a brilliant shining light. Gabriel arrived in glory. What a terrifying sight!
What the flippin' heck is happening? Seth and Colin, wake up now. Aliens, or even Martians. Don't look at them, hit the ground.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to scare you. It's the halo, I suppose. But I have some information. Excuse me, while I strike a pose. Not that one? Do not fear, I bring glad tidings. News of joy for all the earth. News about a special baby. News about a new king's birth.
Get up off the ground there, Amos. There's no need to hide your face. Martians, it's a blooming angel, not some dude from out of space.
Look, there's loads there, singing glory. Glory be to God on high. Peace on earth to everybody. Angels filling all the sky!
Hurry now to David's city, Bethlehem, and you will see, wrapped in cloth and in a manger, Lord of all eternity. Get a move on then, stop gawping!
So the shepherds left the hillside and just off the city square. Found the house with Mary, Joseph, and the baby lying there.
Ain't he lovely? Who'd have thought it? Me old Amos being here.
right before the Lord of Glory. Makes me knees go sort of queer.
I feel I should have brought a present, but I couldn't think of what to bring. What could shepherds give a baby, Lord of Lords and King of Kings?
I've brought wool for him to sleep on. Comfier than straw or hay. Smells of sheep, I know. But this is from the art. Is that okay?
So the shepherds knelt and worshipped, feet on earth and eyes on heaven. Jesus slept and snuggled softly on the wool that they had given. Sure, it had no fancy wrapping, ribbons, none, nor sparkly bow. But the gift they gave to Jesus came with love instead of show. So as Colin, Seth and Amos went back to their dozing sheep, Jesus somehow went there with them, giving presents they could keep. Later on, a group of wise men.
Actually, Harvey, ours are women.
Travelled in from lands afar. Scientists, we'd call them these days. Following a bright new star.
Are we nearly there yet, Gaspar? Been travelling for weeks. Can you just remind me why we've come and what it is we seek?
Melchior, have you forgotten? Honestly, you noodle brain, we bring gifts to greet and welcome, celebrate a new king's reign.
All our books and all our wisdom told us that the star so bright means that king and god and saviour will be born this very night.
When the wise men stopped their journey, what they found was quite a shock. Mary, Joseph, babe in manger, shepherds outside with their flock.
Can I check this is the right place? I bought gold to crown a king. I wonder, where's this palace? Is this stable quite the thing?
I brought incense, pure and holy, made to worship God on high. Is this baby, weak and helpless, mighty God with human cry?
I brought myrrh, to symbolise the one who died, to save us all. Such a strange gift for a baby. Job too big for one so small.
So the wise men gave their presents, though they didn't understand how the child who lay before them would one day give this command. Follow me, he'd call to many. Preach good news in all, he said. Heal the sick and free the captives. Would they follow where he led? Gave his life to pay our ransom, bought us all at costly price, righteous King and God and Saviour, perfect Lamb as sacrifice. Raised to life to raise us with him, Victor, Christ and living Word, all this lay before the baby, sleeping soundly, undisturbed. So the wise men knelt around him, gave their costly presents then. Suddenly they knew what they'd be taking treasure home with them. Richer than the purest incense, costlier than gold or myrrh, wise men took home truest wisdom, Prince of Peace and Comfort.
Proceeding, guide us to your heavenly light.
our story's almost ended. Everyone has met him here. Will you take the Christmas baby home with you throughout the year? Let us hear from all the people who have met with God today. How will this affect their stories? Will this change them? Who can say?
Strangest night, but stranger morning. Joy and sadness like a sword. When I kiss my baby's forehead, I believe I kiss my Lord.
Though I'm his adopted father, I will raise him as my son. I will teach him all I know, and I will love him, serve him as my king until kingdom come.
I don't really understand it, all the stuff the angels said. But I know I knelt and worshipped by the Lord Almighty's bed.
Why would God come down to shepherds, poor his folk of all the poor, live with us and make us worthy? I don't know, but I adore.
What have I to give to Jesus? Nothing. And yet everything, all my heart and soul, and worship for the baby, God and King.
God I brought expecting royals, majesty I found instead, higher king than all kings ever, lying in a manger bed.
I brought incense made for worship, rising as a prayer to heaven. Prayers now answered by the baby, God's own gift to me is given.
Myrrh I bought, not understanding how this babe would die or live, bringing life in all its fullness, gifts that only he could give.
So God's plan before creation, earth in heaven and heaven on earth, came in the form of a gentle baby, mighty God in human birth.
Now Emmanuel is with us. Christmas is forever true. In your home, if you'll invite him, God with you and you and you. God on earth and God in heaven. God with every human heart. Greatest gift that e'er was given. We and God no more apart.
Shout with us the Christmas story. Let all heaven and earth declare. Jesus came to earth from glory. God is with us everywhere.
Now all our characters are in the crib scene. Let's come to a point where we bless that crib. Dear friends, as we celebrate the birth of Christ, let us pray that God will bless this crib, that all who worship his Son, born of the Virgin Mary, may come to share his life in glory. God our Father, on this day your Son Jesus Christ was born of the Virgin Mary and for us and for our salvation. Bless this crib which we have prepared to celebrate that holy birth. May all who see it be strengthened in faith and receive the fullness of life he came to bring, who is alive and reigns forever. Amen.
Thank you.
come to the blessing. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the Magi, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always. Amen.
Well, there we have it, the Christmas story. And this year we might not be with our loved ones, but we will be together in spirit and in love with God at the centre of all that we do. So it just leaves me to say, I wish you a very, very happy Christmas. Have a wonderful time with whoever you're with, and we'll look forward to seeing you in the new year.
And remember, wherever you are, God is with us everywhere. Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
How God came.
Never lying in a manger bed. This needs to be a wrap up.
It really does.
Seagulls. Now I've got seagulls.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
It's really attractive.
Oh, I'm loving it.
I should have had all this
encapsulated. With those whom we love through spirit. So we just want to welcome.
Oh, it was going so well, it was beautiful. Thank you.